Hey guys, in today's topic, we are going to discuss about electricity. Now, what is electricity? Electricity is a physical phenomenon associated with the flow of electric charge, more specifically through the flow of electrons through the conductors. Electricity is a form of energy that comes in positive or negative form. Electricity is all around us, powering technology like our cell phones, computers, fans, lights, and so on. In our practical life, we may have experienced a force that when a scale is rubbed on a fabric and takes nearer to the small pieces of paper, those papers get attracted to the scale. Now, how does this happen? To understand this, we have to focus into the structure of the atoms. Atoms has a positive center called nucleus. Electrons, which are negatively charged, rotates around the nucleus. Generally, the electrons of the outer orbit or valence electrons are loosely attached by the nucleus than that of the electrons of the orbit nearer to the nucleus. Hence, it is easy to discharge the outer electrons when externally force is applied, such as friction force. So when we say an object is negatively charged, then it contains excess electrons. And when we say an object is positively charged, we mean it's missing for electrons. Now, when we rub the scale on fabric, the electrons jump to the fabric because of tendency of attraction of the fabric is more. So scale loses its electron and it gets positively charged. Thus, when we bring it to the smaller pieces of paper, it attracts the electrons of the paper. Because of the light weight, the papers gets attached to the scale. This causes electrons to move from one place to another. When the electrons flow between two points, we call this electricity. One of the most dramatic state of electricity is a lightning strike. An electrically charged cloud release their charge in an explosive flash. To use this electricity, we need to find a way to contain the flow of charged particles. That is what a battery cell does. A battery is a chemical device capable of stored chemical energy into an electrical energy. Batteries have two terminals or ends, that is, one is negative and positive. This reflects negative and positive charges on the electrons and protons. Battery creates a force that move electrons out of the negative end and attracts them on the metal bar on positive end. Electrons will start to move from negative to positive end if the right kind of material is connected to the battery. These materials are called conductors. Copper is the most common metals used in wires. A conductor is connected to each terminal of the battery. Electrons start to move traveling from negative terminal to positive terminal. This is electricity. One important thing we must remember that we must never connect a short metal wire between the terminals of a battery. This is a short circuit. The wire will get hot and we might burn ourselves. Hence, the battery will lose its energy. Now let us see a simple circuit. The path that electric current follows is called a circuit. This circuit has a light bulb in it. To move electricity through bulb, we connect the metal wire in each end of the battery. The wire does not get hot because the light bulb reduces the current flowing from the circuit. Electric energy changes to light energy. Once the circuit is complete, electric current appears flowing from negative end to positive end of the battery. Current tells us the rate at which electrons are flowing through the battery. I hope you find this video very informative. Next time, I will be back with more videos regarding electricity. Thank you. Have a nice day.